Up until now, we've only been able to find the area of either a right triangle or a non-right triangle whose altitude we know. But now what we're going to do is we're going to look at a way to find the area of a triangle regardless of whether we know the altitude or not. We can find the area of any triangle by taking 1/2 times two side lengths times the sine of their included angle. So notice I'm needing a situation of side angle side. I may not always have that, but I may be able to create or get that by using first law of sines or law of cosines. And I can choose any side and angle that I want, and that'll kind of show an example too. Let's go ahead and start with example one. So like before, I'm going to start by drawing my triangle. So let's see, I have triangle G, H, J, and I know G is 7, so I'm going to be across from side or angle G. H is 10, and I'm told J is 108 degrees. So notice that I have a side, an angle, and a side, so I don't need to use law of sines or law of cosines. I can go ahead and plug them right into the formula. So my area of this triangle is going to be 1/2 times two sides, so 7 and 10, times the sine of their angle in between, so sine of angle J. All I'm going to do from here is put that into my calculator. My calculator knows order of operations, again making sure I'm in degrees. And I get 33.287 rounding to three decimals. And I wasn't given a unit, but had I been given a unit, it would be a unit squared since it is dealing with area. Let's look at the second example. Go ahead and jump right into that. In my second example, I'm finding the area of triangle ABC. So again, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to draw it. So here's my triangle ABC. And I'm told A is 2.5. And I'm told B is 8, and I'm told C is 6. And again, sides A, B, and C are across from angles A, B, and C. So notice that I am not given an in-between angle. In fact, I'm not given any angle at all. So I'm going to have to either use law of sines or law of cosines. As I've previously stated, I don't like to memorize which case I use which law in. So I just always assume I'm going to use law of sines. But notice when I try to set up a proportion, I would have to do an angle over a side, that would give me an unknown, equal to an angle over another side. Well, that doesn't work because that gives me a second unknown. So if I try to instead use angle C and side C, I still have a second unknown. Since I have two unknowns, I realize that law of sines won't work, and I'm going to go ahead and try to do law of cosines. It doesn't matter which angle I try to solve for. I'm going to go ahead and solve for A. Again, there's no particular reasoning for that. But I'm going to start with the side across from it. So the square of any side is equal to the sum of the squares, so 8 squared plus 6 squared, minus twice the product of the other two sides, so 2 times 8 times 6, times the cosine of their angle in between, so cosine of A. I'll subtract 8 squared and 6 squared first, following my solving process I learned back in Algebra 1. And then I'm going to go ahead and divide by negative 2, 8, 6, because once I get cosine of A by itself, I can use the inverse to solve for my angle measure. And as before, I can go ahead and put this into my calculator. I do have to make sure to put parentheses around the top and the bottom. And doing that, I've already put that into my calculator, and I get 0.977 equals cosine of A. My 7 kind of looks like a 2, so let me try to fix that. There we go. 977. Now I can go ahead and take cosine inverse. Because again, I use the inverse to find an angle, and I get that angle A is equal to 12.312 degrees. Now that I have a side, and an angle in between, I can go ahead and say that area is equal to 1/2 times the two sides times the sine of the angle in between. Again, my calculator knows order of operations, so I put this in and I get 5.118. Again, I'm not given units, but had I been given units, I would make sure and square those units. So that is going to be how we find the area of a non-right triangle, just 1/2 times two sides times the sine of the angle in between. The angle must be in the two sides. So make sure if you have any questions on this, you bring them into class with you so that we can talk about them.